So in our previous lecture, we were discussing something about the vector space model, right? Like when we retrieve documents from the web or from different sources, what is the way or what is the methodology that that is used basically, or how the similarity computation is being taken and how the documents have been retrieved and how they need to be ranked, because the retrieval basically has so many number. It is like when we go for retrieval, so many documents get retrieved because the similarity coefficient matrix basically, or the formula, it matches with many of the documents. Maybe like some will match 100%, some will match 90%, 60%, 40%, whatever may be. But we need to understand that, like, which documents need to be retrieved first, then the next document, and the next document, and the next document. So ranking of this document is important for us. So what is the process of ranking? That also we have seen. Now, that was the vector space model, basically what we have seen it. So as I said to you that we are having also probabilistic models, and totally in literature we are having some 9 retrieval strategies, but we will be going through here in this particular course like only vector space model for introduction to you about the retrieval systems and then the language. Okay, so when we come to language model, how a language model uses this retrieval, or how a language model can be used in the information retrieval. A statistical language model is basically a probabilistic mechanism for generating a piece of text. It defines the distribution over all the possible word sequences. Now you see, when we speak something to Alexa or Google Assistant, it needs to gather the data, right? And exactly that matching of the words and matching of the sequences, so, or like which piece of text it needs to generate first of all, and then it needs to go for its conventional searching into the using the search engines. Then afterwards it needs to retrieve back the solution. So what it takes is that it takes this particular piece of text with respect to the distribution over all the possible word sequences. Maybe like sometimes I may ask you like, what is your name? Or maybe I can ask you, what's the name? Like that. Or like maybe like, you know that for asking a question, we can have a jumbled way, maybe like a name yours, I can ask, right? So this way, so whatever may be the piece of text, it tries to check out like what are all the possible sequences of that particular text that is given. Now, the core idea is that documents can be ranked in their likelihood of generating the query. It means to say that suppose given a query, which document does this particular set of words or sequence of words consist of? So when we consider a spoken document recognition, if the speaker were to utter the words in the document, maybe like, what is the possibility that, or what is the likelihood that they would occur the words? They would occur maybe like some specific word which is available in the document as the next word in the query. So suppose you give it, even in Google, sometimes when you are giving it, right? Like, what is the, you type it in the Google, then you get so many suggestions, right? We get so many suggestions. So these suggestions, if you take into consideration, like which one need to be again ranked first? If you simply see what is the, okay, what is the, you write it there, okay, or maybe like some typo also, typing your for some spelling, S-A-T, suppose you write it S-A-T, so what is the next, S-A-T, sat in the, or sat in, or sat here, or satisfaction, or maybe like something related with sat, okay, starting with sat. So all these options will be there for you, recommendations will be there for you, but which one need to be ranked first? Okay, there are so many recommendations for you, available options, but how do we rank them? So maybe like what you need to say is that, like, what is the possibility that this particular sentence or this particular set of sequence of words will be asked for this query? So here you need to understand that this language model, basically the idea here is, the core idea is, like, the document can be ranked on the likelihood of generating the query. So which document can be ranked first? Okay. So the similarity coefficient of the language model can be given as like this. The similarity coefficient of the query with respect to that particular document DI is nothing but, you try now here, P of, or let us assume that this is the probability of that query into that particular language model which the document consists of. Yes, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So probability of this query into that particular language model. So here MDI is the language model which is implicit to that particular document which you are considering. Okay. So few people like Pont and Croft models, the presence or absence of any term, these are the pioneers in that retrieval strategies, okay, using language model. So Pont and Croft models, the presence or absence of any term as an independent Bernoulli event, and view the generation of the whole query as a joint event of observing all the query terms and not observing any terms that are not present in the query. So what you need to understand is that here, suppose I give a few words, maybe like some what is that, or like I wanted to query in the query, who is the president of India? Okay, who is the president of India? Then what happens here is that the documents, it has to take into consideration. Suppose you take a document, okay, now assume that we are having maybe like who is the president of India. A document comprises of all these words, who is the president of India. It may not be in the same sequence, but it has to find out basically like how many documents basically comprise this one. Maybe like some documents may be comprised of some 50%. So when you type in the Google, you can just see that like this is absent. Okay, suppose you give it like who is the president of India, maybe like some documents will come into picture very nicely, like that web pages will come, but some maybe like here president of India is missing, or who is the is missing, president of India is available, but this is missing, or this is missing, so like that. So now if you take into consideration here, these language models, basically their core idea was that it was taken into consideration both the presence and absence of the terms, list of terms query. So you considering this, the similarity coefficient, the above given, like the similarity coefficient between Q and DI can be reframed as, see, product of all the terms which consist in the query and which is available in that particular document into product of all the terms which is not available in that query and which consists in that particular document model. So it is given like similarity coefficient between Q and DI is given as product of TJ belongs to Q, P of TI, TJ given MDI, that language model of that particular document DI, into product of TJ, which does not belong to the query, 1 minus P of TJ given MDI. Now, our target is to compute these both, right? This term 1 and term 2. P of TJ given MDI and 1 minus P of TJ given MDI. The one, if you get it, the other one automatically you will get it, okay? Now, so the model P of TJ given MDI can be estimated possibly in different ways, but one of the methods that can be given is that P of TJ given MDI can be given like this, like PML, is nothing but the maximum likelihood. What is the maximum likelihood probability of TJ given MDI? PML, TJ given MDI. So where PML, TJ, MDI is the maximum likelihood estimate of the term distribution. So it is like the relative term frequency, term distribution given, so taking into consideration the relative frequency, and it can be given. See, like if you take it this probabilistic way, it can be given as PML, TJ given MDI is given as TF, the term frequency of TJ, DI. This particular term in this particular document DI divided by the document length. Okay, where DLDI is the document length of DI, total number of frequencies. Now, if you take, so our interest now is, see, you know, you understand here that first of all, we wanted to compute the similarity coefficient. Then in order to find out the similarity coefficient, we need to find out the maximum likelihood. So maximum likelihood, how do we compute it? Using the term frequencies. Okay, term frequency given by the document length. Now, so one by one, we are moving forward, like how the computation takes place. So the similarity, but here one of the major problem that which comes into picture is that zero occurrences of the terms. So if you see the similarity measure given earlier, okay, here what we have even explained till now works fine, but has a big problem. The term in the query does not occur in the document. The whole similarity measure becomes zero, because you are using the product here again. Okay, so if you consider this particular term, like an example, document 1, document 2, document 3, and the query which is given here. The document 1 consists of the sentence like shipment of gold damaged in a fire, document 2 as a delivery of silver arrived in a silver truck, and document 3 comprising of the words, terms like shipment of gold arrived in a truck, and the query is gold, silver, and truck. So, if you see here the example, the term silver does not appear in document D1 and D3. Similarly, gold does not appear in D2. So if you consider the similarity coefficient for like a P of silver, probability of silver given MDI. So here term frequency of silver given DI divided by document length DI, you are going to get zero. So unavailability of a particular word in the document. So to avoid these zero occurrences, why not we give, instead of giving simply zero, why not we give some value to that one? So that is one of the ideas. Maybe like those are negligible ideas, values only, but we need to give some values for that one. So that is the process, what we call it as smoothing. Smoothing the values, okay? Earlier also we have seen smoothing, right? When we are seeing the language model, How did we do the smoothing and all? Maybe like using some distribution activities or something like that, some distributional strategy, or maybe like a borrowing from somewhere. So we entered into that one and we saw that, right? How we can do the smoothing activity while for the zero occurrences of the words. So to avoid the zero occurrences by terms, various smoothing approaches exist, and like which estimate the non-zero values for these particular terms. So instead of zero, we try to substitute, or we try to give some values for these particular terms. And one approach assumes that the query term could occur in this model, but simply at no higher rate than the chance of it occurring in some other, all the other documents. So we are trying to take into consideration with respect to the whole documents. Then we can get some values for that one. So maybe like the ratio here, CFT is the number of occurrences of that particular term in the entire collection divided by the number of terms in the entire collection, total number of terms in the collection. So if you see CFT by CS, this one can be proposed, or instead of putting zero for a particular term which does not occur in a particular document, why not we try to take into consideration about that term occurring in the entire collection? How many times it has occurred? So if you take the example of the silver, see here, two times it has occurred. So in the previous example, if I go through here, delivery of silver arrived in a silver truck. So two times it has occurred, right? Silver, silver, two times occurred in the entire collection, if you take into consideration, the entire, considering D1, D2 and D3, like that. So two times it has occurred. Out of how many terms? Totally 22. If you consider this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. 22. Out of 22 terms, okay, 22 terms in D1, D2, D3 combined, okay, two times silver occurred. So it can be, silver can be given the value as 0.091 instead of 0. The value, okay. So an additional adjustment is made to account for the reality that these document models are based solely with respect to the individual documents. So when considering this one, individual documents, it will be a small sample size, but when we consider the entire sample size, we can follow like this. P average of T, okay, P average of T can be given as this sigma, or summing up with respect to all the maximum likelihood, sigma D. You want to take only those documents where the term occurs. So T belongs to D. PML of T given MD divided by D of T, that is nothing but the document frequency of that particular term T. Another thing that we need to consider is that the risk factor that is involved. So to improve the effectiveness of the estimate of the term weights, maybe like some will occur, means like in some documents it may, like you are trying to take into consideration in a particular document with the weight that it occurred in some other document, right? So this one, it is possible to minimize the risk that is involved in our estimate. So what we try to do is that before that, finding out the risk, we try to find out the mean term frequency of a particular term T in the document. So this FT bar, okay, can be this mean term frequency FT bar can be computed using this formula, like FT bar can be given as P average of T into document length of document length, okay, DLD. So this, the risk can be obtained using this FT. Okay, now the risk can be obtained using this formula, RTD term with respect to the document is equal to 1 by 1 plus FT bar into FT bar by 1 plus FT bar power TFTD, term frequency of that particular document. Okay, now the term weight is now estimated. Now you see here PT given probability of that particular term given MDI, okay, that language model which is pertaining to that particular document DI is given using this formula. So if it is zero, if it is greater than zero, means if a term occurs more than once or like more than zero times, it means that at one or more, then you have to use this particular formula, PML into T comma D raised to power 1 minus the risk factor R of TD into P average of this particular term T raised to power risk of T comma D. So this is otherwise what you have to do, it means that when it is zero occurrences, you simply use this CFT, the term frequency for that entire collection divided by the entire collection, number of terms in the entire collection. Otherwise, okay, if a situation occurs that the term does not occur, then in that case you can use the term below or the formula below, down one. So here you try to calculate the maximum, this probability of the term given MDI. So considering the example, let us see how we can compute this one. Like again, how we can use this one. The same example has been considered. Okay, like shipment of gold damaged in a fire, delivery of the silver arrived in a silver truck, and shipment of gold arrived in a truck. And the query that is given is gold, silver, and truck. So initially, when you compute like a total number of collection, the documents that are available is like individual documents length is document one, we are having 7 terms, document two, we are having 8 terms, and document three, we are having 7 terms. And the total collection of documents, these are tokens, or with respect to the complete entire collection, we are having some 22 tokens here. So the document frequency of terms, DFT, okay, the document frequency of the terms, T, with respect to the documents, okay, DFT, if you take into consideration DFT, so A occurred 3 times, arrived occurred 2 times, damaged occurred once, right? Now silver occurred once. We are trying to take with respect to the entire collection, okay, and unique words. These are the unique words, okay, in how many documents it has occurred. Now the row count for token T in the entire collection, CFT, is same, but only thing, like if a word occurred 2 times in a particular document, then here we have to represent, like here if you see, both these are same. Now DFT and CFT is same, but only silver value has changed, right? The silver value has changed because it occurred 2 times in a particular document. So here you are trying to take it, the entire collection, irrespective of the uniqueness. Okay, here only unique words, how many times it has occurred, you are trying to take it, DFT and CFT. Now, with respect to individual document, the row term frequency of terms T in document D, so that is nothing but TFTD. With respect to individual documents, if you take it, how many times these particular terms occurred. In D1, A occurred once, arrived occurred 0 times, damaged occurred once, delivery occurred 0 times, fire occurred once, gold occurred once, in occurred once, like that. If you see how many times the particular words occur. So when you work it out, always you need to see that, like for your exams and all, suppose you are given, you have to arrange them in some chronology, like maybe like A, arrived, damaged, delivery, so that we do not miss any terms in any of the term from any of the document. So it is better, always better that you have to arrange them in some order. There is not a necessity that hard and fast rule that you have to do it like that, but simply for our easiness, okay? If we do it like that, maybe like we do not miss any of the terms. That's why. Now, we need to calculate the maximum probability of the maximum likelihood, or the maximum likelihood probability of T given MD, the maximum likelihood estimate of the probability of term T under the term distribution for document D. So for each term T, the PML is given like this. Maximum likelihood probability of T given MDI is given as TFTD by DLD, document length, right? So for example, the term frequency of A, here you see this is A, okay? A for that particular document D1 divided by the document length D1 is given by, so A occurred 1 time divided by total number of terms in that particular document is 7 times. So we rise to like 0.143, that is 1 divided by 7, 1 up by 1/7. Okay, now, so similarly, you have to calculate for that particular all the documents, all the terms, okay, the row term frequency of term T in document D, for that particular document D, or that is a TFTD, is to be calculated for all the terms in the entire collection, Okay. So for silver, how it will be? Silver, if you see here, this is silver, it means that 2 divided by how many, what are the terms, how many terms occur? 2 divided by 8, right? 2 divided by 8, that is nothing but 0.250. Now, we can calculate the mean probability of term, because why we need to calculate the mean probability? Because we need to calculate the risk factor that is involved, right? So we calculate the mean probability of term T in document which contains the term. Now, if you see here, P average of T is equal to sigma D, like for that particular term which belongs to D only, that documents only need to be considered, and PML, maximum likelihood probability of T given MDI given by DFT, the document length. So for the term arrived, it only appears in D2 and D3. So P average of arrived for that particular term here, okay? So you have to consider which are the documents that is arrived. Only that documents only you need to take into consideration, right? So PML, maximum likelihood probability of arrived in MD2 for document 2, and PML of that arrived for document D3. It is available only in D2 and D3. It is not available in any other D1. So that's why you are not considering D1 here. So divided by document frequency of arrived. How many documents did this arrived occur? So this is, you are trying to take the average probability, right, of that particular term. So that, again, using this particular table, earlier table, DTFTD, okay, that using that you substitute that values like PML, maximum likelihood probability of arrived in MD2 D2 plus maximum likelihood probability of arrived in D3. So if you see, it is 0.125 plus 0.143 divided by total document length is 2. So that is, you are arriving to some. So P average probability of arrived is 0.134, 0.134. The average probability for each term like that need to be calculated. So this is like, for example, term A, arrived, damaged, delivery, fire, gold, in, off, shipment, silver, truck, like that. You need to calculate average for all the terms in this way. Okay. So now trying to find out the mean term frequencies. So if you need mean term frequency, if you need to calculate the risk, what do you need to do it? You need to first of all calculate the mean term frequency. If mean term frequency has to be calculated, then you need to have the average, P average. So that what we have done it. So P average we have calculated, and then now this mean term frequency, simply we calculate or we multiply that one with the document length, right? So for example, the mean term frequency of arrived in the document D1 is given by mean term frequency F bar arrived is equal to P average of arrived into document length of D1. That is nothing but 0.134 into 7, that is equal to 0.938. This is how we get it. So now, similarly, we need to find the mean term frequency for all the documents, all the terms. So this is the computed values. If we are having a live class here, we generally, I ask you all to calculate it and you do it. But since it's an online lecture, just I have already computed it, so just I'm giving you the display. So make sure that you go through this, okay? You recompute this one once and check it. You can check it just by recomputing it. This and this language model, generally when we take in the live class, we require a 2 hours lecture, because you need to calculate a few things and maybe like fill the tables and all. So generally some time is being consumed there, but here I am computing it. It is already computed. The values are being directly projected for you. Now you try to calculate the risk, right? So let us calculate the risk values per term per document. Now RTD, the formula is given by 1 by 1 plus mean term frequency into mean term frequency by 1 plus mean term frequency power TFTD. Okay, so for example, arrived, we wanted to calculate risk for arrived in a document D1. How we can do it? 1 by 1 plus 0.98 for arrived. If you see earlier, for D1 it is 0.938, right? 938 by 1 plus 0.938. So into 0.938 by 1.0 plus or like 1 plus 0.938 power, you have to give here TFTD. If you see TFTD, right, earlier arrived for TFTD, the row term frequency of term T in document D1 is given as 0 here, right? It is 0. So that's why we gave here the value 0, okay, power 0. That's equal to this value into this value is nothing but anything power 0 is 1 only. So 0.516, that was the value that we have arrived for arrived. Okay, the risk value for arrived. Similarly, you have to calculate for all the values or all the terms in all the documents. The risk need to be calculated. Fine. Now, so once risk is calculated, then we go back to the original formula. We use the risk value as a mixing parameter to calculate the probability of producing the query for a given document model, P of query given that document model MD. Okay, so P of T given MD I is given as the formula earlier what we have seen. This PML, if TF, this term frequency of T comma D is greater than 0, then you have to follow this particular formula. If it is 0, then you need to formula CFT by CS. So for example, the probability of A in the document D1 is given as probability of A given DI is equal to PML. So it is because like it is greater than 0, right? It occurred once. A occurred once at least in the in that particular document. That's why you have to use particularly this formula. Okay. So PML of T comma DI power 1 minus the risk factor of T comma DI into P average of T comma power the risk factor, that's nothing but you are going to give point this, all these are substituted values only. Okay, values that you need to substitute from different tables what we have computed earlier. Once you compute this, then you are going to get the value. Okay, whatever. So the expected probability for each term with smoothing, you can find out that with smoothing, this is the values. Okay. So some values are bold. Okay, given in bold, like 0.143, like this gold here, silver is there, and truck here. If you see that, where is truck? Sorry, gold. Okay, here in D1, D2, 3. So, few places we have bolded it like that. So in the table, they match with the query terms. Right? Now, we are interested in finding out the similarity coefficient between query Q and the document DI is computed with the original formula that first what we have seen, with the presence of the terms and the absence of the terms in the query. Okay, so now after finding out this formula, you need to formula, you need to find out for similarity coefficient between Q and D1, similarity coefficient between the query and the D2, similarity coefficient between the query and D3. You can compute it with the presence and the absence of the terms. So if you do it, you also find out what is the final rankings. You can find out. Okay. So these are some references, and thank you. And so anything need to be clarified, you can ask.